Good afternoon. My name is Turner Bitten. I'm the executive director here at Westview Media. Thank you for tuning in to our latest Candid Candidates event. Today, we're joined by Salt Lake County Mayor Jenny Wilson. Thank you for joining us.
Well, thank you, Turner. I think it's great what you're doing, and it gives the folks in your area a chance to hear from so many different candidates. So thank you for inviting me and for doing these, all of the forums that you've been producing over the last little bit.
Yeah, we appreciate your time, and I know how busy and strange this time is, and I'm sure that there's a lot of demand for your time. But we appreciate you spending the time with us. So to get started, why don't you just tell us a little bit about yourself and kind of how you came into public service? I know you were on the county council before you were the county mayor, and maybe just give folks your origin story, if you will.
Well, sure. I'm a Salt Lake City girl. I went to East High and then the University of Utah. I had the unique opportunity. My dad was a mayor when I grew up, Ted Wilson, mayor of Salt Lake City from about 1976 to the mid 80s. So I grew up in public life a little bit with him. And I'll tell you, Utah, Salt Lake was a different place, but a lot of the benefits of Utah and Salt Lake still remain. So I later, after my University of Utah degree, went off to Washington, D.C. and spent some time there. I worked for a congressman and ran a congressional office, Congressman Bill Orton. He was there in the 90s and had a great experience there. It was during the Clinton years. And I was also actually working for Congress the year that after many, many years, the Democrats had controlled the House of Representatives, it shifted for the first time to Republican hands, all the while I was working there. So it was a fascinating time to be in Washington. And then I ended up coming back to Utah for a brief period of time. Went and received a master's degree from Harvard, master's in public administration, and then ended up back in Utah permanently, raising my kids here, met my husband, who is also an East High alum, and I went on to work for the Olympic Games, was one of the senior volunteer leaders that ran the volunteer program, and it's an exciting time, and around that time, started my family, ended up running for county council, and was elected in 2004 to the Salt Lake County Council, served there 10 years, took a break during that time, actually went up to the University of Utah and worked for the Moran Eye Center. And I'll tell you right now during COVID, to know what's going on generally up with the University of Utah Hospital is a very, very big help. Now mayor, I took over for Ben McAdams when he made it to Congress and was put in office by the Democratic Central Committee for 2 years, and now I'm up for a full 4-year term. So I guess that's the highlights. My biggest focus in my life are my kids. My second biggest focus, of course, is the residents of Salt Lake County and my work there. And I enjoy what I do, although I'll admit this has been a challenging year for sure for us all.
Yeah, I can imagine. Well, I appreciate, again, your time today, and I just wanted to ask what you think the most important role that the county mayor plays?
Well, right now, it's fighting COVID. Cases up. I was able to utilize a couple of tools earlier. One was join many throughout the nation in making sure that we were closing appropriate businesses when we knew there was spread and issuing a stay home order. I think that was essential for us to buy some time to control cases and then also to figure out what the heck was going on with the virus. We then opened up and with that, we were able through Salt Lake County's interventions to generally pull back on the virus. But with schools opening, so much going on in the community in the fall. In fact, I'll reflect a little on that. In my head during the summer was like, how do we do the right thing around the 4th of July and the 24th of July in our summer? And I kind of, in my own head, didn't recognize the rituals and the connectivity that we have in our community in the fall. And it's about sports and it's about kids getting together and all those things that we encourage that we frankly had to discourage or do differently during COVID. The other tool that I had was the mask mandate. It was very controversial. I to this day know it was the right decision. And I'm definitely in the camp of if we can manage our health, we will see an economic recovery. Indeed, we've seen that. We're one of the strongest economies in the nation. All the while, we have people that have been left behind that we have to laser-like support. And we're doing that at Salt Lake County, administering $40 million in grants. Actually, I don't know that we hit 40 million. We offered 40 million to small businesses. And I don't know if we'll get quite to that number, but we put a ceiling on a fund and we're able to get out millions and millions into the community to businesses that were specifically impacted. And then again, we've been coordinating with the hospitals, working with the state. The state has the primary focus on testing, but we do targeted testing. Did a lot of that on the west side when we recognized cases were higher in certain zip codes and with certain communities, our Latinx community, Pacific Islander community. I mean, really, unfortunately, you know, communities of color often don't have a choice with some of the work that they do in construction and other types of jobs that have been impacted disproportionately. Large families in our Pacific Islander community, hard to social distance in a home when one might be ill. So we've been working through that. There are a lot of other key priorities. Air quality is still, you know, a major concern for us in this region, and we've got to battle it and do better. We see a housing crisis, and that housing crisis is affecting many people, but it's getting harder and harder as we see land being developed and so little opportunity to do things in the right way. So I've been battling to make sure we have the appropriate density in the right places to accommodate our growth in this valley. And then of course, homelessness is impacting us all. And I do think we're making progress. Although during COVID, it's trickier because we have fewer people in our shelters and more people, unfortunately, on our streets. And we've been hands-on addressing COVID need. So it's a big portfolio. The canyons, again, appropriate development. Those are all duties of the mayor. Mental health, general health is a concern. Running our health department well, not just with COVID, but with other issues. So the Salt Lake County mayor has a very, very large portfolio, and I've got great teams working in all of those areas.
Well, thank you. You have quite the portfolio, and just wondering what kind of made you decide that, yes, I want to be the county mayor, and what keeps you in the fight, if you will?
You know, I remember a day, early new council member, had 8 colleagues, interestingly at the time, all men. I was the first woman elected to the Salt Lake County Council. But I remember in our first budget review, I had a lot of help from my colleagues to understand that process. And I remember I turned to one of them and I said, I'd like to put some more money into substance abuse and mental health. And my colleague looked at me, he said, make the motion. And that night I made a motion that passed that put an additional $1 million into substance abuse and mental health. And I realized at that moment that I could have an impact and an influence. And that's what led me to continue serving on the county council. You know, public life can be challenging, and my kids would probably agree with that. It hasn't been easy lately because of the demands and frankly, a lot of unkind direction towards my office and sometimes me, and certainly to the director of health, people calling in that are not being kind to the many people trying to help manning phones as we try and deal with COVID. And I'll tell you what led me to running for mayor is the concern that I have in this community, the love that I have for the community, and the understanding that I can make a difference. And I've learned along the way, I have to be tough at times. I always try to be fair. We have more than 20 jurisdictions, and I think it's 23, but I have to, Brighton's new. We had 17 cities, we now have 5 townships, so 22, but we are, I guess 23 if you include the unincorporated area that we still have in Salt Lake County. Each of those communities has great people, great identity, great culture. We're as different as Alta, Utah is to West Valley, is to Magna, is to Salt Lake City, and everyone in between. So with that, there are needs in each of those communities, and I've enjoyed my association with our municipal leaders to problem solve kind of me with from this regional perspective and them serving their local communities. So I enjoy what I do. There are days, but it's very rewarding to see progress for areas I think matter to our community.
Thank you. The next question I wanted to get into is, in your role as mayor, one of your most important roles is selecting people, as you said, surrounding yourself with a team to help carry out your vision for the county. And just wanted to kind of get your general philosophy on managing teams and how you work with a county council that's majority Republican and you're a Democrat, and just kind of learning about how you manage a team and work with a team.
Well, thank you for that question. So I had the opportunity to form a really strong alliance with Mayor Ben McAdam. So I was able to work really closely with his leadership team. And I knew their strength and their sense of commitment to their jobs and their expertise. So I realized when I was elected that I already had a great framework for framing my priorities and creating a leadership team that would follow. So I did make a little bit of change, and we ended up going, the Mayor McAdams had four deputy mayors, and I shifted to have three. And then he had two associate deputy mayors, and I shifted to have three. So he had six senior leaders. I have six senior leaders. And that those three leaders manage very, very large portfolios from arts and culture oversight, recreation, finance is the lead for one, as well as our internal affairs, like our HR department and our IT, our technology folks, et cetera. And then another one is focused regionally on public works and some of those services, including economic development. So they each have really robust portfolios, and it's been, they understand the complexity of their work. We do a lot of work with cities, as I mentioned, trying to figure out how we can deploy county resources fairly throughout the community. Transportation being a big concern, planning being a big concern, our canyons, et cetera. So I think my management style is to help on a new initiative, help frame it, have my priorities, and I've mentioned some of them, air quality, housing affordability, now COVID, which means health, and frankly, retooling a health department that will work beyond COVID and be more responsive to the risk that we now know worldwide is at our doorstep. So I try to frame a way and make some decisions related to our global budgets. Your point about and question about the county council is valid. I come from that body, so I know their journeys. I know how much each of the nine council members cares about their districts. And I think we have a great collaboration. It's a little different right now, frankly, and I think they would agree, because we're in a declared emergency and our systems are different than they traditionally are. So they remain partners and they're boots on the ground and they have a great connection to their various communities. But right now we're operating just with more emergency management integration, and I've elevated our health department right now so that I can be hands-on as it relates to COVID. But I try and take on a lot every day, but try not to micromanage. And I'm really involved in forming plans and ideas and growth strategies. And then it's up to my teams to execute.
Thank you. I know that I already asked you about the issues in your race, but just wanted to give you an opportunity to build on any specific issue. I should rephrase, what do you think is the biggest issue this year in the Salt Lake County mayor's race?
I think it's COVID. It's and I'll tell you that it is, COVID is is a tricky, tricky virus. It is aggressive. And my projections, I talk about this 100-mile marathon. And at one point I'm like, I think we're at mile 26. And then I thought we were at mile 60, and we're not. I hope we're at mile 50 during COVID right now in a 100-mile race. Assuming that's the case, the last 50 miles are as tricky as the first. I'm concerned at this moment. I had a report today that we have very few ICU beds available. I know our healthcare systems can adapt and do things differently within the walls of our skilled facilities for some time, but we're going to get to the point, if we don't see cases stabilize, we're going to need a field hospital. Our venue in Sandy is available for that, and was, you know, earlier the feds came in with the state and everything's ready to go, and it will be set up within 2 days if we need that. That will be a dark day in our community. And I continue to emphasize the need to wear masks. I'm now upping my conversations with my kids about, you know, when my kids went off to school, they did see a couple of friends. I told them no parties, no big groups. And now I'm reining that back. We have to mitigate the spread of this virus. I move around the county still, and I've seen some misses. I've seen misses at football games, seen misses on construction sites, and I'm worried. So we're doing right now, I mean, one of the tasks I handed off today was we got to work with our construction crews and companies. It's not the men and women on the ground. It's they're trying to do their jobs. The senior leadership teams there have to do something differently. And I would just encourage everyone to, there are a lot of benefits, frankly, to additional time at home. There's not any benefits to COVID, or very few, but there is a, I mean, I see a closer personal connection with my kids. I'm having more meaningful conversations with my parents, though not in person as often, and we're social distancing and wearing masks when we do. It's tough. There's nothing to say other than this is tough for us all, but we've got to just prepare for the last 50 miles if it's another 50 to go, and hang in there. I'll tell you, I believe that a change right now, handing off the keys to another mayor, is not a good thing for this county. I don't think that my team's done everything perfectly, but I think we've done things very, very well. I'd probably do a few things differently if I could rewind time. I know I would. But every day we double down, we do the work, we have long days, we're kind of stressed and tired, but we're committed. And the shift that would happen, I mean, I wouldn't want to be, for some reason, term limited out and hand over the keys to the office to someone that I worked with even, because this is such every minute right now for the people doing this work matters. And so, you know, I do have differences with my opponent, but even if I were somebody I really closely aligned with, now's not the time. So COVID right now, but we also, our teams continue to, you know, I'm on Canyon related meetings on a regular basis. We continue to move that issue. The homelessness issue is, I think I have as many meetings as I used to on that. We just are dealing with some different challenges due to COVID. We're still doing traditional work, just longer days. And our deepest concern right now is getting through COVID so that we can recover. Our finances are hanging in there from a kind of global county level. So that's the good news. We'll recover quickly when we can finally get to the point of the vaccine administration in our county.
Well, thank you. I'm going to do just a couple of quick questions. We don't have to get into the weeds on these, but they came up as you were doing your introduction and just kind of talking about issues, and wanted to give you an opportunity to build on top of some previous statements. But just a general thoughts on growth and development in the county and kind of how you approach that issue.
Well, we have very little land left to develop. There's a couple of big projects coming, the port. I supported Salt Lake City's lawsuit in challenging the state action on that. And I have concerns about the port. I think we're still stuck in a mentality that we need to grow in this valley. However, I will continue to try and mitigate, assuming that future challenges to that case aren't realized and the port becomes a reality, I will continue to fight for air quality, sustainability, good planning, and mitigate any negative impacts. We still have a mentality that we have to fight. And I was actually on a call with senior leaders involved in the Olympic Games the other day and said, look, I was a part of the staff team for the Olympics in 2002. And we, the sort of framework we had in terms of let's use the games to let the world know who we are, the games change. The world knows who we are. What we have to do is manage the land that remains. We have to do it well. So I'm part of a collaborative effort on the prison site. The prison, of course, is moving to Salt Lake City, the Northwest Quadrant. We need to mitigate issues surrounding that. And I continue to support Salt Lake City and its efforts around that. But on the site that remains, we need to make sure that we are not overbuilding, that we're planning correctly. There's been a lot of questions around Olympia Hills. I don't know that everyone's completely versed on that development, but in that case, the developer or the private property owner had rights and the county asked for a planned community. There are still people in that area who aren't happy about it, but I think what we did was force the developer to the table to create a Daybreak-like community that has trails and parks and will be, we put as much as you could within the framework of developer rights, we required commercial so that you don't just have a big housing development with people having no walkable amenities to a grocery store and other, and jobs on site. That's really, really key. So those are the kind of where we have those bigger acres priorities we have to make. And that's going to include some density. We can't continue to have our growth at the levels we're having and not build density. It's just not possible. And I think it's naive to think that you can. And unfortunately, it is what it is. You know, I wouldn't question anybody's personal choices around, you know, where they want to live or size of families or what have you. But the reality is we have to look at data and recognize we got a lot of growth. And when it comes to growth, the preservation of our quality life is my highest concern. How do we make sure that our choices are based on facts, evidence, and well thought out? And that's really, and again, you know, with multiple municipalities who have their own planning and zoning authority, it can be a little tricky from the regional point of view.
Thank you. The next question, I'm going to lump all transit together. I actually received a question in advance from Mark, and Mark asked about east-west transit options. I believe Mark lived actually in the southwest part of the county. But I'm going to lump all public transit and pedestrian and bicycling together and just kind of ask about transit in general.
Well, back when I worked in Congress in the 90s, my boss, Bill Orton, was part of the coalition to fund the first line that went from downtown Salt Lake to Sandy, the Red Line. And I remember there was huge resistance. So that was a critical time. My office and I supported him and his with his voice in Congress for that funding. And we worked closely with UTA even back then. Interestingly, one of the first things I did as a county council member was support an additional sales tax increment to build the four lines. And I was part of the push to require the airport line. And that addresses the north side of the valley, east to west. I was part of the initiative to push for the West Valley extension, and there's another east to west. And then right now, in fact, I was with Mayor Overson of Taylorsville today, and we talked a minute about the bus rapid transit that they have scoped, and they're excited about that. That'll be Taylorsville to Murray. I go to Kearns on a regular basis, and no, it's impossible. We've done some creative things, and I'm getting off transit a little bit, transportation planning, with the lanes that shift. And I was actually out going to Taylorsville this morning and drove that direction on those expanded lanes. And all of a sudden I had an X, you know, I was phasing in. I wasn't that spaced out, but I had to shift over. Those type of solutions are really helping east to west. We need to continue to move lines that direction. I'll tell you, it's a lot harder to get from Salt Lake City to Point of the Mountain, or it's faster to get from Salt Lake City to say IKEA than to get to move off of, you know, 45th or that, any of those directions in the center of the Valley West. I get it. And one of the challenges is we didn't create dedicated lanes back in the day. So it's right away is really, really challenging as we look at those solutions. Part of the Mountain View Highway plan was to address some of that, because if you can get over to a north-south quickly, that helps too, unless your final destination is truly east-west. And so I think we're doing a lot. I'm an active member of the Wasatch Front Regional Council addressing these issues. And look forward to, you know, we got to find the bucks, right? That's always tricky. So as we roll off previous projects, continuing the investment in other areas, that's going to be really, really important out in the Harriman, South Jordan, West Jordan, Riverton area, as we look at growth in that section of the valley, which is, you know, fast and furious.
Thank you. I know we're running short on time. So my second to last question, I guess it's not a question. I just want to give you an opportunity to tell voters directly why they should support you as opposed to your opponent. What's your kind of closing statement, if you will?
Well, thank you. I love my job. I don't think it's the time to turn the keys over to another mayor. We've had a lot of success in the year and a half, almost 2 years that I've had the opportunity to serve. And I'm committed to this job. We have an amazing leadership team. I believe we have the right priorities, battling and trying to find market solutions and other opportunities for the high cost of housing. We rallied fast and faster than the state, and I think more efficiently than the state as it related to COVID. And they have great people, and I don't want to say that they don't. I just think we were nimble, committed, and willing to do that tough work. I'm a hands-on mayor. I know what's going on in my county. I have deep commitment to it. And the 10 years on the county council prepared me. I know our budgets. I introduced a budget just this week that's balanced, even in the midst of COVID. We have a AAA bond rating. We are very, very well run. We invest in good employees, and I'm proud of the work they do. Cities, counties invest in their people, and I'm certainly do that as well, and know that in the end, we're rolling out important solutions, including investing in air quality. One of the first things I did was support additional resources and create an Office of Environmental Sustainability to get on air quality. I've done a lot around domestic violence. We've seen cases go up. I've been a partner recently to get food into the community, and I've been very concerned about our county's west side. We've seen higher cases there, and there are specific needs there that we're on top of with a great leadership team. So there's a lot to say, but in limited time, I think that about does it.
Well, thank you so much. My second to last question for you is, how can folks find out more information? What's your website and contact information?
Yeah, wilsonformayor.com. We've got information there. What I would encourage everyone to do is find your ballot. It's a big yellow, I've already returned mine, so I don't have one here, but big yellow envelope if you haven't seen it. Fill it out. There's some good resources you can, if you want to know, there's a site, and I don't have the resource in front of me, but you can Google and figure out rankings on judges, because there's a lot of judges. There's constitutional amendments. There's information out, the voter guide. And I hope you'll support Jenny Wilson for county mayor. I feel this is my highest honor to, as hard as it's been to be mayor during COVID, and I think it's necessary that I see it through with a great team and help us rebuild, which is my priority for the next 4 years.
Thank you. And for those that are watching live and those that are watching the recording of this, this was recorded on Thursday, October 22nd. Tomorrow, October 23rd, is the online voter registration deadline, but you can register to vote at the polls. And we encourage you to do that at vote.utah.gov. The last question that I have for you, and this is one I like to do with every candidate, but is there anything that I should have asked you or issues that I should have brought up that I didn't?
No, I don't think so. I think this has been a great interview. I appreciate you guys taking the time with me and with other candidates. I really do. It's one of the tricky things about COVID is we're campaigning differently. So any opportunity to reach voters and connect is really appreciated and gives me a chance to understand what's on people's minds as well. So thank you.
Well, thank you. And I know that you're very busy, and I've appreciated our time today. Thank you for running for office during this crazy time. We appreciate your leadership and public service.
Oh, I appreciate you. Thank you, Turner.
All right, take care.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.